Well, should Christians go to church regularly and belong to a local body of believers? Welcome back to Up for Debate. I'm Julie Royce, and today we're discussing this notion that church attendance, at least attendance at a formal local church, is optional. According to the Barna Group, only 36% of Americans go to church, and of those who don't attend church, 40% say that they find God elsewhere. 35% say church is not relevant to me personally. Someone who shares those sentiments is best-selling Christian author, conference speaker, and blogger Donald Miller. Miller actually wrote a blog last year entitled Why I Don't Go to Church Very Often, which went viral and then sparked a lot of controversy. And here's Miller explaining himself online to the editors of Relevant Magazine.
I don't get a lot out of church when I go. I don't connect with God very well there. And I wondered if it wasn't more of a learning style issue, because it is a lecture format sort of a thing, and it's not how everybody learns. People learn in different ways, but there's really one way to learn, at least in the Sunday morning service. So probably about 5 years ago, I stopped attending with any regularity. And it's really funny because for a couple of years, I didn't go, but I would still tithe, right? I would still like send my money because I love the people. I love my pastor and I were good friends, but I just kind of realized this isn't the most efficient use of my time. The pushback that I kept getting online was, you know, you're being really selfish. This is narcissism. The church isn't about you and these kinds of things. So that part of it kind of hurt, because I hope I'm not a narcissist. I hope I'm not walking to church saying, please me. And I also hope that none of us have to go to church because we hate it and it's our obligation, right? I don't know any pastor who'd stand up and say, we're going to make this as uncomfortable for you as possible because it's not about you. They wouldn't have a very big church. So some of that is kind of unrealistic. But the blog was really intended to start a conversation about the millions of people who are like me who simply don't learn that way. And I don't experience community sitting with 200 other people facing forward and hearing a lecture. That's not community to me.
Well, I think many who've left feel like Donald Miller did. And it's not just, it didn't minister to me, it wasn't my deal, but the feeling like there's no engagement with God. We're sitting through a performance, and that's more of today's mega churches probably than other places, where it's just a pretty slick mini concert, mini lecture. Often, and then there's the no experience of community, because if we're just sitting looking at the back of each other's heads, and then the rest of the week it's committee meetings and worship practices, and it's things that really doesn't spawn community from really spending time together and hearing each other's stories. And I think those are two of the big things. The third one is people's the feeling of the duplicity and manipulation of those in leadership. I think that's why people leave. It's not because they don't love people here, it's they don't care about people. But this, there's a lot going on that we're not told about, and then from the pulpit is often this manipulation that comes from guilt and shame and obligation to do what we think is best for you. And it doesn't encourage people into the kind of relationship that transforms. So I think that's why people say, man, I'm going to look for something different, and many people have found it. That's why people are not rushing back in saying, wow, I didn't find it away from that. When I was a pastor, I didn't even conceive that there was a real thriving life of the church beyond the institutions I was a part of.
But what about the house church? I mean, isn't that sort of the reaction to everything that you just said, that there's house churches? But at least in the house church, there is formal leadership. There is a weekly gathering. There is a weekly teaching. Why not the house church?
Yeah, many honestly don't survive long. Many people, they're easy to start. People get together, they're angry, they're frustrated, they're going to have this new thing. And then they realize it's the same as the old thing. It's just smaller. It's still obligation to somebody telling me what I should do for God, and it's not equipping me to love God and live deeply in Him. And so I think they're mostly short-lived, and people go, okay, that didn't do it either. Not that meeting in homes isn't awesome, mm-hmm. but when it just spawned the same structure again, the same obligation-based structure, it's not going to be spiritually fruitful.